So if you're using Google Sheets and you have some data that looks like this on the left, and you want to make it apparent that it's a table, use some nice colors, make it obvious what the headers and the title are. That's what we're going to do in this tutorial. So we're going to start with unformatted and work our way over to something that looks like this. So here we go. If we do one cell, let's say we wanted to do A1, you hover over it with the mouse and you left click one time. That selects it. Don't double click. If you double click, it brings you inside the cell and it thinks that you want to change the contents of it. The second way that we're going to select data is you're going to either select the entire column, and I did that by left clicking on the A, or you can do the entire row. So let's left click on the 2. And while that's highlighted, if you hold down the shift key, you can go down and it selects more than one at a time. And you can also select the entire sheet by clicking up here in the upper left-hand corner. That's everything. So when you're looking at this data, the first thing that you want to do is make it apparent that these are dollars. I'm going to highlight all of those. So I just left clicked in F3. I held down the shift key and I used the right and down arrows to select this entire range. And I'm going to go up and just click the dollar sign in the toolbar that formats it as currency. But then I want to go to column F because I don't really find it to be material what the cents are on a particular item. I kind of want it on the totals because I want to see everything down to the penny. But here, let's just go ahead and decrease the decimal places. But I want you to see, for example, this is $1.99. If I decrease it by 2, oops, wrong way. If I decrease it by 2, it rounds for me. So Google Sheets uses a standard rounding convention, and this turns $19.99 into $20. Now the value in here is still $19.99. Okay, if I double click, it's in there, but we've changed just how it's displayed. Now let's take this sample data. This is the title of the entire table. It's not a header for a particular column. So we should probably merge these rows. So I left clicked in A1, I held down the shift key, and I pressed the right arrow. Or you can just take your mouse, left click, select all these, left click and drag. And let's merge cells. This little icon here is merging them. So you merge them together, but I want it centered horizontally as well. So this icon gives you three options: center it left, center it in the middle, center it to the right. Let's put it in the middle. And then let's make it bold. That would be right here. And we're going to make it 24 point. So you really see, hey, this table was sample data. Actually, I'm going to make it a little smaller. It's kind of annoying. There we go. Now what I want to do is a really handy shortcut that was added just a few months ago to Google Sheets. I'm going to select what I'm considering to be the table here. But if you see, I also selected the header, which is row 2, and the footer, which is row 7. You'll see why here. I go to format. I'm going to say alternating colors. Why it doesn't just say format it as a table, I don't know, but alternating colors. And then on the right hand side, it brings up these options. Now I have a header and it doesn't know that I have a footer. You have to tell it that. And I say I have a footer as well. Did you see the row 7 there became darker? I'm going to unclick it and click it again. And then you just choose the color and hit done. Now when you look at this, it looks more like a table. It's apparent that these are the types of units that we're looking at. This is the content, the actual data, and let's make it more apparent though that these down here are totals. I selected E6. I'm going to hold down my control key and select G6. So that enables you to select two individual cells at once, two or more. And what I'm going to do here is put a bottom border on it. I'm not doing an underline. I'm doing a bottom border, and I'm going to explain the difference. First, I'll let you see it. There's the two bottom borders. I didn't do an underline because if you resort this data for some reason, the underline's going to move. But if you do a bottom border, it should stay with row 6. Now, I also don't like this font. So let's use the trick where you select the entire worksheet by clicking in the upper left-hand corner. And then we'll drop down the font and we'll change it to Calibri. And I think that it would be better if the header, the content of the cells in the header, was center aligned. So let's just click on the 2 to select that entire row and then go to the vertical alignment, which is here, align it vertically. Now let's say, look, I want to zoom in 200% on this, but when I do, things are too wide. So I'm going to make the unit cost, I'm going to put a space in here. You'll see why in a little bit. I'm going to make the unit cost a lot skinnier, like this. And I'm going to make the unit skinnier, and then maybe I could see everything. Let's make it a little bit more skinny, a little bit more. All right. What happened here was I made it so skinny that the units isn't fitting well. So what I have to do is, or one of the options that I can do is to rotate it. You can do this with all your headers if you want. You could select row 2 and rotate it. The other option, this unit cost is also running over a little bit. I'm going to shrink it some more so you can tell. And what I'm doing to shrink this, I'm just changing the column width by hovering over the line that separates the two, holding down the left mouse button and moving left and right. All right, so my other option to make this fit, well, I could just shrink the font, but a fancier option is to wrap the text, which is this middle option. You see that put one over the other. Now, if you don't like how the others are all down at the bottom of the row, because now the row is taller, let's change the horizontal alignment. That would be, where would that be? Vertical alignment, excuse me. Let's change the vertical alignment. Let's put them in the middle. Now they're all lined up. So that should pretty much cover the basic things that you can do with your data to format it into, in the end, make it look more like a table. Draw the user's eye down to the important parts, or up to the important parts like the header, or down to the footer. Let's go ahead and make these bold. That way it's more apparent that they're the sum. And that's about all for the basics. So I hope that's helpful to you. And if you want to see more tips like this, you can subscribe to this channel and see what else comes out. Thanks.